Sorry, you
is
don't...
that lipstick on your collar? Are you kidding me?
Sorry,
you know, don't even answer that because I know what the answer is. You two have been sneaking around. Oh, yeah. And then he was just so grateful for you being so special. I'm going to go inside and I'm going to get rid of these stupid tears. And I promise you that this is the last time that I will ever cry over either of you.
No, Star, wait.
Happy birthday, Star.
Nice tux, Todd. You check your rifle in the coat room?
What happened? I figured certainly you'd be back in Texas by now. Did your welfare run out?
I thought I'd give you a chance to prove yourself. You want to shoot me, right? Let's see you look me in the eye and pull the trigger.
This can't be good.
You see, Rex over there looks like he's in need of some parental guidance. Why don't you go play daddy with him?
Are you going to shut up and listen to me? Or do I have to make an announcement right now that you are not Jared Buchanan, but that you are, in fact, my son, Jared Banks?
Mayor Lowell, how nice of you to join us.
Well, I've never been able to say no to Dorian.
Stan, have you met the newest Buchanan, young Jared?
No, I don't believe I have.
Would you like me to introduce you?
Oh, dear.
I had no idea the two of them knew each other so well. Did you, Vicky?
So what'll be, Charlie's sidecar or just one?
Just cut the crap, Jared. I saw the way you were looking at Vicky's daughter when she came in here.
Well, it's none of your business.
No, you made her my business tonight. Look, I've been walking around this town like a jackass, claiming to be someone I'm not, pretending that some other kid is my son, and it's all in an effort to let you pursue this crazy dream of becoming a Buchanan.
You know, if you were ever a father to me, this whole noble sacrifice routine years might actually have some impact.
Damn it, Jared, I have no control over the past, but I do have some kind of control over what's happening here and now. You want to be Jared Buchanan? Then you are going to be Natalie's uncle.
Keep your voice
down. And no uncle ever looked at his niece the way you were looking at her tonight. Listen, are you trying to hurt that girl? Because I'm not going to let you hurt her. And if you ever look at her like that again, then I swear to God, I'm going to blow your little scam sky high.
When I said that Allison's escape was all my fault, I meant it literally. I broke her out.
Oh, don't tell me that.
I'm not going to lie to you.
No, what you mean is you're not going to lie to me anymore, right?
I had my reasons.
And your reasons? What reasons could you possibly have for breaking Allison Perkins out of jail? Am I wrong? Am I wrong, or has Allison Perkins done more damage to your family than anyone on this planet? Tell me exactly what you did.
Oh, I see that something's bothering you. I wish you would just tell me what it is.
All right, come on. I gotta tell Clint North to.
Hi.
Hi. Clint and I were just going to go dance.
No, just wait one second, please. I hate to throw a wet blanket on everything, but you two need to know Allison Perkins escaped from St. Anne's.
Lindsay Rappaport. You go, girl. You never told me she had her fangs in bow.
It's news to me.
They're slipping rocks.
Listen, baby, you're on the land, and I think we better amscray.
Don't be a party pooper. We're not going anywhere.
But don't be a wacko if they catch you. You gotta be back at St. Annie's.
Not till I've had my fun.
eyes would shut up when I walked into the room. It was because you were playing this party, right?
Pretty much.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Do you guys hate me?
No, of course not.
We've just been playing this party ever since we found out we forgot your birthday. I can't believe that I would ever think that you guys would be hooking up together. Could you ever forgive me?
Oh, if she pisses him off.
She must know how dangerous Todd is.
No, you don't know Gigi. She sees a fire, she runs for gasoline.
Well, look, if you think you need to bail her out.
Wouldn't mind?
Nope, no.
Oh, where's your boy off to?
So what happened the other night? Just a little performance anxiety.
Won't be the first time.
Have any idea what Allison's intentions are? Trying to figure it out. We may not know anything until she surfaces.
Well, you should ask Lindsay.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, you did collaborate on a jailbreak once before, and you were just in St. Anne's with her.
What the hell are you talking about? I never saw her at St. Anne's.
Let's not do this now, all right? You two ought to call Nigel. He's trying to coordinate security at your house.
That's what we'll do. See you later.
Sorry about that.
It's not Nora I'm worried about. It's Allison. On the run after all these years.
She knows how to kill a buzz, doesn't she?
Is this the way high society gets all? Just swaying, standing around.
That's why they drink.
Did your two officers just happen to bump into each other tonight?
Just a coincidence. Pure coincidence.
Yep.
I need to talk to you two for a minute.
Oh, man, I was just looking for you.
Well, what's up with you? Why are you hyperventilating?
All right, Mary J. Blige.
Well, she's here?
Yeah, dude, she just got here. She's in the back getting ready. Oh, my God, I was so close to her.
What would you say?
Well, I wanted to say, hey, what's up, Mary J.? I'm, like, psyched that you're playing for us tonight, and I think you're awesome, but all I came out was... Hi. I'm not even sure that came out.
The star's gonna freak when she finds out Mary J's performing. She'll forget she was ever upset.
Dude, we have to go see her. Come on.
Mayor, excuse me. I see my niece.
Excuse me.
Sarah. Bless you. Hi, darling. Hey. Rescue me from that woman.
Oh, something's never changed.
That's true.
In Texas.
Yeah, for a really long time. We missed you, Aunt Vicky.
Well, thank you, darling. I missed you all, too, and it's good to be back.
I think it's pretty cool, you know? You're reinventing yourself.
Darling, I took a page out of your book.
Hi, guys.
Really?
Hey.
Honey, you decided to come. Are you feeling better?
Yeah, the headache just kind of went away.
Oh, good, good, good.
Hi, hey.
You look great, man. I'm telling you, all this red is...
Thanks, nice. Red. I'm sorry, Mom, can I speak to you for a minute?
Oh, sure.
We got to scoot. I mean, yeah. He needs to monopolize the playlist.
Right. Okay. Something lively. Please, lively.
Definitely. Yeah.
Thank you, honey. Everything all right?
No, actually. Can we go somewhere to talk, or are you waiting for Charlie?
No, actually, Charlie went off somewhere with your uncle.
He goes right over there.
Not that uncle. The other uncle. Jared.
Getting all moral on us, are you? Must be the new girly friend.
If you think I'm not serious, you are dead wrong.
Oh, so what? You can lie like a dog to Vicky, but when it comes to Natalie...
This is different. How?
How is it different?
Are you trying to hurt this girl? I mean, are you getting your kicks out of torturing her?
I would never hurt Natalie. Never.
Well, then you've got a choice to make. Either tell her the truth or back off.
If I do tell the truth, it's going to be over between you and Vicky. She's going to see you for exactly who you are.
Buddy, that's a chance that I'm willing to take.
Wait. So you're willing to sacrifice for me? It's touching, Dad. Tad late, but
you still want to hate me? Fine. But you're my son, and whether you like it or not, I will try to protect you. Not. Okay. Look, I don't approve of what you're doing here, the lion of the Buchanan's trying to weasel your way into their family. But I understand that this is something you feel you need to do. But you can't have it both ways, not with Natalie. Look, if you really care about her, you better tell her the truth. You owe her that much. You owe that to yourself.
Where was this kind of concern when I needed it? Were you so worried about what I was owed when you walked out of my life?
We can't go back, Jerry.
You can't. That's for sure. Because then you might actually have to take responsibility for what you did.
But that wasn't my decision. Your mother asked me to leave.
Oh, so you're the victim now, huh? You only do what you're told?
No, at the time I was a drunk, and I did what I thought was the best thing for everyone.
Yes, the best thing. To abandon your family, to let that sadistic son of a bitch come into your house and raise your kids instead of you.
I didn't know.
You're right. You didn't know. Why not? Huh? No, you know what? Don't answer that. I know the answer. You didn't care.
No, that's not true, Jerry.
Oh, so you let that bastard come into our house and sleep in our mother's bed. But as long as you were off the hook, it was okay that he beat her up. That he beat us up?
No, she never told me. Nobody, if somebody had just told... Jared, I didn't know.
You didn't care.
No, that's not true. You cannot accuse me of that. I did care, but I was an... I am an alcoholic, and I was too busy hating myself to... Okay, never mind. It's not going to be about me.
Not for a change.
Look, what I did to you, just leaving you to fend for yourselves, that was inexcusable. But then what happened?
Don't stop right there.
No, that was an accident, Jared.
I will not talk to you about that. I will never talk to you about that. Understand?
Jared's with Charlie?
Yeah. Apparently they've discovered they have something in common. Anyway, I assume you want to talk to me about Allison?
Yeah, you can do this in private.
Sure, sweetheart. Sorry.
So that's the famous Gigi. That's her. I don't know. I imagined her blonder. Gigi is Rex's ex-girlfriend from high school. Or maybe his baby's mom. Layla! I already told you that kid is not Rex's.
It didn't sound like you believed it.
Well, I do. Gigi swore to it. Why'd you even bring it up?
Oh, Rex has a kid?
Vincent, you're not listening, okay? Yes, Gigi has a little boy, and he has nothing to do with Rex. Nothing, okay?
I don't think that Allison's going to get very far, but I just wanted you two to know.
What can we do to help?
Nothing, really. Just want you to enjoy it.
Is Jessica now?
We're watching her. She'll be okay.
The last time Allison had a secret, Ben ended up dead, and my mother was almost killed. I am not going to let that woman torpedo my life again.
And now she's wandering around out there on her own. And from what I've heard, if Allison wants to launch a torpedo, no one's going to get in her way.
If Antonio had his way, we'd have nothing but land bans.
Wow. I always knew Landview had a lot of secrets.
That's right. And they're all in that box.
Oh, look at this one. It's beautiful. There's some kind of inscription on it.
Hey, you know what? The music is picking up. I'm going to go dance. Come on.
No, wait. I want to read. They say that it hits you like a thunderstorm and I am drenched. Like walking through a crowded room and knowing which one has your heart. Those are my lyrics. Someone took my... You? Mind if I steal Vincent for a dance?
Girl, you better go and take your man back. That Gigi woman can fight her own damn battles. Go.
Does Adriana know about your little waitress friend?
I'm nobody's waitress. The only man in my life is my son. And if you do anything to hurt him in any way, I'll get a gun too, and I won't miss.
I actually believe you. But I don't want you to worry about it, because I'm not the one to worry about. The only man to worry about in this room is Rex.
So when is this big celebration?
Yeah, when do we get to burn all these secrets, Lindsay?
At midnight.
I hope that fire's hot. If the thing fizzles out, there's going to be a lot of nervous people around. So what do they call a secret that doesn't burn?
Evidence.
Oh, incoming.
I believe you all know our mayor, Stan Lowell.
Hello, Mayor Lowell. I'm sure you remember Lindsay Rappaport. Who could forget her?
We gotta get out of here before we get caught.
I didn't break out of St. Anne's to hide behind a curtain. I got work to do, things to say.
Allison, I'm begging you. Nobody has to know anything.
So you keep that inside, all that pain?
I sure as hell am not going to share it with you.
Okay, but then why this life? Why the Buchanans?
Mom's friend. He had a sister named Pamela. She used to come to the house every weekend, and when she was there, he wouldn't hurt us. She would talk to me about her husband, a very special and powerful man named Asa Buchanan. He was a great, loving father to his sons. Well, I'm not sure if that part was true, but I believed it then. She gave me a picture of the two of them and told me that one day I'd be like him. I used to stare at that picture every day and imagine that Asa Buchanan was my father. Now, I never got a chance to meet him. But when the opportunity came up to be his son, I took it, okay? And I'm not going to let you take that away.
Yes, I won't. I told you that. But as I also told you, if you want to be Jared Buchanan, then you can't be in love with Natalie. So what's it going to be? What's more important to you? The Buchanan name or the woman you love?
Charlie!
Oh, who's that good-looking guy there?
Really? Oh, yeah.
Help me escape and I'll tell you a secret. Are we 7 years old?
Okay. When we searched the mausoleum this morning, there was a little compartment hidden behind a plaque. She wasn't conning me, okay? There was something hidden there, and whatever was there, she got it.
Yeah, I just got to talking with Jared here, and...
That's all right. Yeah. So you two are getting acquainted, huh?
Well, it's a start.
Well, I didn't mean to interrupt. Sorry. Natalie and I were looking for a quiet place to have a chat.
If you wouldn't mind, Miss Davidson, I would appreciate a moment alone with Natalie.
I don't want to talk about the Wanamaker merger.
This isn't about BE, and I don't mean to presume, Miss Davidson. It's just very important to me.
Fine. We'll talk later.
And I would love a dance if you would do me.
Oh, yes, please.
Mm-hmm. So what's up?
I need to talk to you about us.
Lindsay wanted me to design one of the boxes, and when she told me what the concept was, I don't know. I just couldn't get your words out of my head, so, I'm sorry. I should ask you for permission.
Are you kidding? To see something of mine take shape? You have no idea what this means to me. You want to get out of here?
Yeah.
So, is there a secret in there with your name on it?
Well, there certainly should be.
Charlie, are you all right?
Oh, yeah. I'm fine.
Okay. It's for a good cause, you know. I always think it makes you feel better when you write things down. Girl,
would you go over there and say hi before you drive yourself crazy?
Thanks, Rex, but you didn't need to come to my rescue.
I know. You've never needed my help. I just wanted you to know I'm on your side.
Everybody okay? No broken bones?
So Mama leaves in a huff. Says that I ruined the party for her.
Why do we go to these things anyway?
Well, next time let's write a check.
All right, that's it. I've done my civic duty. Can we go?
Were you aboard this bus at the station?
Yes.
Lindsay, congratulations again on your miraculous recovery. Smile, Mayor. Oh, can I talk to you privately?
Yeah.
This will be brief. Excuse me.
Sure.
For you. What's this? Read it. My letter of resignation. Unless you're willing to evict your murderer house guest. I told you where I stand on that. You were very clear.
Yes. You need a pen?
No, I wouldn't give you the satisfaction. You want me out, you're going to have to fire me. Consider it done.
Your badge, Mr. Buchanan.
You're making a mistake, Lou.
It's Mr. Mayor to you. And, no, not my mistake, yours. Your father is dead. The Buchanan's that much less powerful. You're getting weaker by the moment, Bo.
Bo? Is everything all right?
Do you see Bo sitting on that picture? I hope it makes the front page. Mayor embracing ex-con.
Oh, Nora, petty, petty, petty.
No surprise, though.
You've had a very tough week, haven't you? Marcy making bail, your entire case falling apart. Oh, well. C'est la vie.
Please, Allison. All I have are my kids and my bad name. If you take that away from me, you might as well kill me. Please don't hurt the people that I love.
But the truth will set you free, Roxy. The truth will set you free.
Let it go. Please, please, Allison, I'm begging you.
Roxy? Roxy, are you all right? You look like you've been crying.
I think it's just a combination of too much champagne and V8 juice. Well, Vicky, I guess you and me are charter members of the Charlie Club. I hope things work out for you.
Roxy.
Yeah.
Charlie actually told me that, you know, he's Rex's father.
Oh, you got the scoop, then you're in the loop.
I hope you don't mind, Roxy.
Mind, Charlie? I'm internally grateful. You guys have a great time tonight. I gotta go to the ladies' room. My false eyelashes are flagging.
I can imagine it must be awkward for you to discover that you share a child with a virtual stranger.
Well, it just doesn't seem real.
No, how could it, you know? But, you know, I'm sure once you get to know Rex, we don't have to talk about this.
Well, if you don't mind, I'd rather not.
No, I understand. Hey, we haven't had that dance yet.
Well, why don't we see if we can fix that right now?
Aha! She must have found a key.
That's how she got out of the mausoleum, but I doubt that's the reason that she dragged us there in the first place. There has to have been something else hidden.
Like what?
I don't know. I don't know, but you should have seen her. It's like she was in some sort of sacred place or something.
You gotta tell Bo all this.
You could help him to catch her.
I know. Look, I'm gonna go, okay? Can you just stay here with Bree and just guard her with your life, okay? Because if that woman gets her hands on Bree, I...
She won't. On my life.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am Dr. Dorian Lord. I am co-chair of the Go Red Ball, along with Victoria Davidson. We are here tonight on Valentine's Day to salute the American Heart Association and raise money to help fight heart disease. I want to acknowledge everybody's contribution in this room. Thank you, generous people of Landview.
Come on.
What is this? I like it.
Candlelight across your face is nice. The sound of your voice is home. I started falling in a veil of white. My universe.
This is your song, your lyrics.
I got a friend of mine to lay down a couple of tracks for me. We're working on it.
So you ready to get back into music?
You're never ready. You just have to jump.
Most people don't realize that heart disease kills more women annually than all the cancers combined.
And in most cases, heart disease can be avoided.
Diet, exercise, and a positive mental attitude.
I'm a jealous, obsessive shrew, and I can't stand for anyone else to be happy. Not much of a secret, Nora. I thought we agreed we weren't going to talk about us anymore.
Well, I have something I have to say.
You're my uncle, I'm your niece. Let's just leave it at that.
I can't. Okay? Because every time we're together, all I can think about is the first time I saw you sitting behind that desk.
Okay, maybe you want to take a stroll down memory lane, but I don't.
It's not a memory, Natalie. It's a feeling, and I still feel it.
That's all it can be, is a memory or a feeling. We're family now.
Okay, what if we weren't?
Trying to kill me. I've been looking all over for you.
Get out of here, Roxy.
Why are you trying to get rid of me all of a sudden? Allison, what are you planning to do?
And now it gives me.
I'm going to make them all pay.
Our mayor, the Honorable Stanley Lowell.
This worked out better than I could have ever imagined. Go, Roxy. Scram.
On behalf of our hostesses, Victoria Davidson and Dorian Lord.
Allison.
For your extraordinary generosity on behalf of our speech. And with all you land viewers in attendance at this wonderful fundraiser, I think it's an opportune time to make an announcement. Now, I realize this is a happy occasion, and what I'm about to tell you may be unwelcome news to some people, but it will affect your life, so you might as well hear it from the horse's mouth. The fact is, Bo Buchanan is no longer Landview's police commissioner.
Now, what the hell happened?
I know that we're all greatly appreciative of Mr. Buchanan's great service and devotion to this wonderful city, so let's give him a round of applause. And now, I am very proud to tell you, our new commissioner comes with outstanding credentials. Having worked with distinction for many years in the FBI and with a strong recommendation from the Justice Department in Washington, D.C. So, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, let me introduce to you Landview's new Commissioner of Police, Mr. Lee Ramsey.
Finally, I break out of the loony bin. This is the thanks I get. Well, that's it. It's over right now.
You're right about that, Jessica.